Why did you come here today? Why is it important to come to a Swindon Business Show?
Business West obviously covers the South West as well, and I'm a South West boy. And I speak actually as a small businessman. I run my own little business down in Dartmouth, my hilariously unprofitable business down in Dartmouth. And I can learn a great deal on a personal level here. I love events like this. The networking, and you learn what other businesses exist to support your own business. So yeah, I'm here as a punter. Really, I'm giving a talk later on, but I'm here as a punter, to be honest.
So what are you going to be talking about in your keynote?
I'm going to talk about teams and leadership of those teams in fairly stressful environments. I come from a military background, and nowadays I work in expeditions and wildlife filming and doing various projects in various benighted parts of the world. And you see some very interesting behaviours in people in those environments. So that's what I'm going to be talking about. And we all know, anyone who runs a small business knows it's a jungle. It is a jungle. And it's one of the hardest things I've ever done is running a small business. So it's drawing parallels really between the business world and what I do at the moment.
And you know, you talked there, I must admit, I overheard you talking about setting up your own business and working with that. So as you say, you are here, as to use your words, as a punter.
Yeah.
What are the sort of things that you're hoping to glean out of today, talking to different organizations?
It's a very difficult environment, the business environment, over the last 5 or 6 years, I think, because it's fluctuated so much. That's the problem. One minute it's milk and honey and everything's going to be absolutely fine. And the next minute, I read in the Times this morning that Greece is about to forfeit on its debt and the whole EU is going to collapse and we're going to be back where we were. And that unpredictability is very difficult to deal with. And I think this event gives you a great opportunity to see what support exists for your business. One of the things I'm looking at, and this isn't a flagrant plug, it's just looking
at... That's okay, we don't mind flagrant plugs, that's fine, you go ahead.
I'm looking for funding opportunities. I'm looking at different ways I can fund my business. I know there's like government schemes, but there's local schemes as well. And I've already had some fantastic chats with people saying, oh, you might want to explore this option and this option, because we're looking to expand and grow the business. It's just so worthwhile wandering around with a cup of tea in your hand, nattering to people, and you suddenly realise what your business is capable of doing, I think.
So is it actually helping you with the work that you do, the consultancy work that you do, the fact that you are going through that process yourself?
Very much so, very much so. And hats off to anyone who runs a business, really. And having done lots of expeditions and been this military guy, I kind of swaggered into the world of business, and I'd done the telly work and everything. And I was like, oh, well, I'll do that. I'll retire and run a little business. The hardest thing I've ever done, without a doubt. And as I said, just hats off to anyone who does it. I have my complete admiration if you make a success of it. But events like this are really crucial gatherings, and it's incumbent on anyone who comes to something like this to make sure they work the room and they go and have a chat with everyone.
Now, you clearly are very highly motivated about running your own business, so it's all there for you. Who has inspired you along the way? Who has maybe helped you as well?
It's a good question. In terms of the other work I do, the expeditions and on the military side, there's a guy called Blondie Haslow, who's always a great hero of mine on the military side. And if you haven't heard of him, he's really worth looking up. An extraordinary Royal Marine in the Second World War who led the Cockleshell Heroes Raid. And I think he's one of those guys that has sort of made me realize a lot of the qualities he showed translate really well to the business world. He selected the right people. He trained them impeccably. He had the highest personal standards possible in terms of the mission he was undertaking, and he made sure that was transmitted to the people he worked with. He had a clear aim, he had a clear plan for what he was doing, and a clear set of rules. Now, all of that sounds fantastic for a business, doesn't it? You know, he's a very strategic thinker. He looked ahead and realized he had to get the right people on board and have a clear framework to achieve that long-term goal. So in a way, Blondie Haslow kind of always inspired me when I was in the military. It's always inspired me on expeditions. And now I'm running a business. It's inspired me to do that as well.
Now, one of the things, obviously, with your background in expeditions and the military, discipline is a massive part of what anybody does in running a business. Again, has that been a transferable skill for you?
If you made the comment to my PA that I'm a disciplined person, she would literally, she'd pass out with just pure laughter, I think. But yes, I think having a set of standards and an identity is really important. It's one of the things I'm going to talk about a bit today, because it gives you a set of rules by which you go about your business. And I don't use the word business in the broader sense there. I actually mean about running your business. So things like punctuality, things like honesty and I think that gets you a long way nowadays, being a good hand. I saw a very good talk recently on running a business by a very, very successful businesswoman. And she said her overriding thing, having done it for 20 years, was do the right thing. Just do the right thing and it will pay back. People will remember you and they'll help you out. And she said, surround yourself with people you know will do the right thing.
Well, I think that's perfect advice to end on. Monty Halls, thank you very much indeed for your time.
Thanks.
Real pleasure talking to you, and hope your keynote goes well this afternoon.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.